something that's central here. Has this ever happened to you? You're at the game store, presumably at GameStop because there aren't too many other ones, but you've picked out a title, you're damn sure you want it, you've waited online, and you get up to the front, and you're looking at that GameStop clerk right in the eye, and you look down at the title, and you look back at the clerk, and has it ever hit you? Holy shit, what am I really buying here? You look at that mature rating from the ESRB, Entertainment Software Ratings Board, the MPAA of video games. What is that mature title bringing you? What does it have to offer? Is it too much? Am I too immature for this title? Should I really be buying it? What is my resource for answering these questions? Sure, you can read through the game magazines, Game Informer, Game Pro, the websites and everything, and you can get a good idea of what the game's about. But don't you sometimes feel maybe you need more information? Like, in the midst of the game, might a character take a bong hit? Slam some beers? Could he possibly say fuck or shit? And really what it comes down to, and where I draw the line, is do any of the characters in the game ever say the word cock? Because when you said cock in a video game, you set yourself apart. You can be like, yeah, fuck shit, fuck shit, fuck shit, but once you start using the word cock, you're sort of taking things to another level. But is there a resource out there that can help you solve this problem? How do you know if your game will be filled with cock? The ESRB has just the thing you need, and it comes in the form of a convenient website, as well as an Android application. But if you download this wonder, you, in the middle of the GameStop, can whip out your phone and resolve all these issues.
Whip out your phone, and you go in, you launch your ESRB application. Conveniently, you select voice search. Saints Row, 3rd. And we'll take a look at all the Saints Row. We'll grab the 3rd, and we'll see what information we have here.
So the ESRB rating summary for Saints Row the 3rd goes as follows. This is an open-world action-adventure game in which players assume the role of criminals, known as the Saints. As players attempt to take over a fictional city and exact revenge on a rival gang, they engage in driving and combat missions to progress the overall storyline. Players use machine guns, shotguns, swords, rockets, and grenades to injure and kill rival gang members. Players can also shoot at roaming pedestrians, although there is no reward for this action. And in one mission, players shoot at police and civilians to create chaos in a rival gang's territory. One scene prompts players to run over a certain number of pedestrians within a given time. Another sequence allows players to dispatch enemies by putting grenades in their mouths. Players can also use chainsaws to hack at enemies, resulting in scattered chunks of flesh and large pools of blood. During the course of the game, female characters are sometimes dressed in outfits that reveal large amounts of cleavage or buttocks. Characters are occasionally depicted nude, though their nipples and/or genitalia are obscured by pasties or blurry pixels. In one sequence, players can walk through an erotic club containing several phallic sex toys and sexual contraptions. In another mission, players drive around town while an escort and client engage in sexual activity. There's no depiction of sex, only moaning sounds and suggestive dialogue like, "How deep's that going in?" and "That's some tongue you've got there." Some game environments and dialogue contain drug paraphernalia and or other references to drugs, like marijuana leaves and water bongs on a table, a radio DJ telling a caller to try heroin, and the golden goose of what we're looking for, the words fuck, shit, and cock can be heard in the dialogue. There you have it. If you're at the game store, this is information you need at that vital point of sale. This game contains cock. Despite the valiant efforts of the many video game publications and websites that are out there, I think it's pretty clear at this point that they alone will not provide you all the information that you may need to reliably buy a video game. And the ESRB fills in that niche quite nicely. You check out some trailers, gameplay, a little bit of information, maybe some background interviews with the developers. You can get all that online and with the your primary video game magazines and publications. But the ESRB has that niche filled so well, when it comes down to it, And you're just sitting there looking at the title going, wow, how much cock is in this game? Cock-a-doodle-doo, motherfuckers!